Alright. If you're trying to level up in this game, from the very beginning, before you start the main story, or you're too far into the main story, what you want to do is you're going to need a couple of things. One, you need to be level 10. I started as a 10, I'm now 14 because I've been killing these guys. You're also going to need some basic little armor and the Gladius. The Gladius, you can look up a guide on how to get this from the Western Stands. It's a bit of a pain, but it's not that complicated. Just kill some wolves and then steal it from the bigger wolf. Once you got it, get out of there. You can just reload the save and try again as many times as you need to once you've got the wolf to spawn. I recommend being at least a level 8 to 10 to get the Gladius. Once you have it, you can come over here and I'm going to show you how to deal with these werewolves. I'm still too low level to take them on in a straight on fight, but I can still wound them and take off running. They're kind of slow. They don't catch up with you easy, so I'll show you how here. Attack this guy. Then we're gonna book it, because he's pissed. They don't catch up easy. They can hit you once. They don't always do that. Then what you're gonna do is you're gonna run here. Don't go further. Don't go over this area over here. Don't do that. Stay in here. Touch the save crystal. Get your health back. It's kind of tricky. But these guys drop 1,000 experience per guy. A little over 1,000 experience per guy. Which is a lot. Right, this guy and this guy are both pissed. Coming at me. They're leaving. So they won't follow you all the way here. The only way they will is if they drink that Bosch's wine. And that will irritate them. You know, they're drunken idiots is what they are. They'll just follow you all the way over there. That's great if there's only one of them, because then you can just run in there, attack them, run back in, you know. Alright, they're both half. They're both leaving me alone here. Make sure, I mean, you can save your game, but it makes it more sense to save after you've killed one, just to get the experience so you die, you don't worry about getting a loss on your progress. Now it's really good if these guys are far away. He's gonna try to kill me and he just might. Oh man. Yeah, he's gonna follow me all the way here too. He's got that smite. If he's got that smite, he will follow you to the death. Because he knows he's about to do like a final kamikaze on you. So now we can chase this guy down. He won't get to his guy, hopefully, before we kill him. Yeah, he's too far away. So we just kill this guy. Just gonna grab that. Didn't want to leave it. Probably a bit of a risk, but meh. And then once you do that, come over here. Save your progress. And you continue to do that throughout. And that's it, guys. Just do that over and over again. And as you get stronger, you know, I'm level 15. Once you get to like level 30, this will be way easier. You know, you can take them both in one fight. You know, and don't even gotta run back, and then you can just, once you kill both of them, this small little area, just cross between both zones, and then cross back in, get your health back, and you can chain them too. So like if you just go in between these zones and you don't touch this, which is when you're high enough level to do it, you can start chaining them for loot, making it really easy. And this is just This is just Vaughn here. There's nobody else with me. Nobody in my team yet. So, that's it for this one. Go ahead and watch this video if you play this game. Peace.